Hi there, I'm Serge Su, and welcome to macStudioA. In episode 1 from my OS X Adventure series, we demonstrated how to take screenshots using your keyboard. In this episode, we'll be demonstrating how to take screenshots using Mac applications. Topics covered: the two preinstalled Mac applications included with OS X for screen capture, and the difference between the two apps. Let's get started! If you prefer to take screenshots using Mac applications instead of using keyboard keystrokes, as demonstrated in episode 1, then you'll be happy to know that OS X comes pre-installed with two screen capture apps that you can use, namely the Grab and Preview applications. Let's look at the Grab app first. To launch the Grab app, simply click on the launchpad and click on the other folder, and click on the Grab icon to launch it. The Grab app does just that, grabs your screen and creates a screenshot. Before starting a screen capture, Grab has a couple of cool tools that you can launch. One allows you to see the dimensions of your screenshot after a screen capture, and the other allows you to choose from 6 different cursors to be included or not in your screenshot. Incidentally, when using the selection capture, the cursor option is not available. Now, on the Grab menu bar, click Capture. You will notice that you have 4 screen capture options available. These are Capture a Selection, a Window, the Full Screen, or Perform a Time Screen Capture, which we'll be getting to in a moment. Probably the best feature in the Grab app is the Time Screen option. This option has 10 seconds delay before the screen capture is taken, allowing you to set up the screen just the way you like it before the 10 second is up. We'll demonstrate this by capturing the gadgets window option screen and also choose a cursor to be included in the screenshot. We'll just save this screenshot and come back to it later. The Grab app has several limitations. Firstly, it can only save screenshots in the TIFF file format. We'll show you how to save it in a different format using the Preview app a bit later. Secondly, you are unable to edit or add any special effects like annotations to your screenshot. And thirdly, you are unable, when doing a selection screen capture, to move the rectangle around. You may ask then, why use it? Well, unless you want to include different cursors or perform a time-delayed screen capture, then that's probably the only time you would use it. The second screen capture Mac app included in OS X is the Preview app. As of OS X 10.4, Preview now includes a Grab submenu to create screenshots. In my opinion, it's best to use the Preview app from the get-go, as it allows more options not available in Grab. In particular, saving your screenshots in countless formats, 13 in all. To launch Preview, click Launchpad, then click the Preview icon. Now, from the Preview menu bar, click File and scroll down to Take a Screenshot option. You are now presented to take a screenshot from Selection, Window, or the entire screen. We'll just perform a selection screen capture for this example. Incidentally, when performing a selection screen capture using Preview, you can use the same manipulation technique used in option 3 from episode 1 to move the rectangle around. As mentioned before, this is not possible to do using the Grab app. Once the screen capture is taken, you are now able to edit and manipulate it using many effects, such as adding labels, annotations, cropping, and many more, as shown here. We'll just save the screenshot by clicking File on the Preview menu bar and choose Save. Top tip: when saving screenshots in Preview, you are shown only a limited amount of format. But if you hold down the Option key while you click the pop-up menu for format, you are presented with all available formats that you can choose to save your screenshot, a total of 13 in all. Remember the Grab screenshot taken earlier? In order to save the TIFF file in a different format, do a quick look of your screenshot by pressing the space bar and click the preview button in the top right hand corner as shown here. You are now able to edit the screenshot, then save it by going to the menu bar. Click File and click Export, then choose the format you wish to save the screenshot in. And that's that. By the way, the original TIFF screenshot is still preserved. And there you have it. You now have three methods for screen capture when using OS X: using your keyboard, as shown in episode 1, and using the Grab or Preview app, as shown in this episode. Thank you for watching. Please give a thumbs up if you like this video, and don't forget to subscribe to be notified of the latest upcoming episode from this series. Thanks and peace.